our fear. Courage is when we face our fear. Tell those with power, safe in their tower, we will not obey.
March 14th, 2018, 1 month after the shooting in Parkland, Florida. To celebrate this, students all across our nation would host walkouts around 10 a.m. and have 17 minutes of silence. Our school here in Sierra Vista, Baldwin Park, California, did the same. I interviewed a few fellow peers with some questions concerning the issue of the walkout and the walkout itself. Here's what they have to say.
My name is Maddie, and I'm in 12th grade.
My name is Zulema, and I am a senior.
I'm Rosemary Salgado, and I'm currently a senior here at Sierra Vista.
My name is Gerardo Hernandez, and I am a senior at Sierra Vista High School.
Carlos Ortiz, I'm a senior.
Jasmine Camarillo, and I'm in 11th grade.
My name is Kimmy Tran, and I'm in 12th grade.
My name is Vila Vasquez, and I'm a junior at Sierra Vista High School.
I participated in the walkout because I believe that I should be able to exercise my amendments, and I did.
I walked out today because I believe the purpose behind it. I believe that guns should, like, there should be more control on the guns, and there should be more restrictions on them.
I participated because at the time of the event, I feel like our generation got really affected by it.
I participated because I just felt that it was important because Congress isn't listening to us, and I feel that we need to unite and speak up against the issue of, like, gun control.
So a lot of people, not only in California, but all over the nation, want to make a difference for every victim.
It was kind of like a way to, like, show my inner voice. Like, by going there, like, I thought it wasn't gonna make a change, but, like, at least spark a change. Like,
I feel like the walkout was a great way for kids to, I guess, have a voice in a place that might not give it to them. So I participated because I believe in it, and I felt like I wanted to see our generation come together and try to make a difference.
I participated in the walkout because we need to raise awareness of this.
Mostly to hear people's, like, to hear the speeches and what people had to say and people's opinions about what's going on in our country.
Since there's a variety of perspectives concerning the whole idea of the walkout as to the intent, as to why people are participating in it, I wanted to know people's stories, because in the walkout we did have people speak among everyone, and I wanted to know the different perspectives that people had.
To show that I am concerned about a very serious issue at hand.
My stance currently is not to get rid of guns, eliminate. I do believe in the Second Amendment strongly, but I also believe that we made the amendments to be able to amend them. I think we need better gun legislation and gun control.
I believe that when our Second Amendment was made, our founding fathers basically put that for us to be able to defend ourselves against the British, but I don't think they ever had the intention to fully automatic weapons to be used, like, you know, like with regular people.
I am a believer of the Second Amendment. I do believe all of us should have the right to have arms.
I'm not saying that we should get rid of guns. I'm sure there's some use for them as they were created, but I do believe that necessary gun control laws are needed.
People do have the right to own guns, however, not any person.
And we shouldn't be afraid of people with guns on our school grounds. I understand fire drills, earthquake drills, those are natural disasters. Having guns on a campus is a man-made disaster.
I believe that we should just do whatever it takes. takes to make sure that the one place that should be the most safe is.
We have to make a change, and we can, but we have to put the effort to do so.
I believe that they should have a control, like, how the health has to be said, like, we're seen as targets, and, like, we shouldn't have to be afraid to do this.
I believe that it's not the solution, but I believe that it's the beginning.
That they should do laws on venues won't make it difference. But it's a stepping stone.
I believe that everyone should actually consider other people's ideas and not entirely like bash them or undermine them.
I believe that having something as simple as a pistol in house is not enough to protect your family. I don't think people should have to watch it as a automatic weapon.
It should be 21. It shouldn't be in the hands of a teenager.
So many changes that should be made. It's really incomprehensible that I can just focus on one. We need to regulate guns. We need to assess more mental health, like, more mental health care.
I feel like there should definitely be more checking into an individual's history before they're allowed to buy any firearm.
So the gun show loophole, that because at gun shows you need a background check to purchase a gun, we should change that and always have background checks.
I feel like the Congress should pass laws where you have to be a certain age to own certain type of guns. You should have, like, you should pass a certain test to be able to get it. Like, it should
be that there should be strict background checks as to, like, owning guns, and they should be kept, like, regular checks, like, every 2 months.
I think that we need to change the age for people to have a gun. I also think we don't need weapons of war. If you need a gun, get a pistol. You don't need a machine gun. You don't.
I made this documentary for our congresspeople so they can hear our voice and what we as a generation want for our future. And I also made this documentary to share our story, to show future generations that change is possible. Now, to end this documentary, I have a couple highlights from our own walkout. Enjoy, and thank you.
Make them hear you. Make them hear.